Now, if you were passing by the Peace Tower at around noon hour today, you would have heard this Christmas carol. Well, my next guest, Pierre Massie, braved the cold and the rain, determined just to hear it. And that's because Pierre happens to be the composer of the piece. The carol is called Mourning Dove, and it wasn't originally composed for Carillon, but for the a cappella choir he directs here in Ottawa, the Stairwell Carollers. He's back from the hill now, and he joins me in studio this afternoon. Pierre, thanks for coming in.
You're very welcome.
Now, you usually hear this piece sung in a choir. How did it sound from the bells at the top of the Peace Tower?
Unbelievable. You know, one of those life moments for sure. She did such a wonderful job of rearranging it so that it worked for the Carillon. And I was really impressed by how well it came through, considering that, you know, usually my stuff has 5-6 voices. And really with the Carillon, you can only do pretty much 4. And if you're lucky, you might get a 5th in there. Okay. So it was really impressive to see. She's amazing.
So when you've got a choir, you've broken it into 5 or so different parts of the overall dynamic range of the song.
Yeah. Sometimes it'll be just, you know, I'll do a 4-voice part with the ladies and then I'll bring the men in. But I have a tendency to start off fairly simple. And next thing you know, I'm adding another voice and another one and another one. But I was pretty surprised that she was able to pull it off, and she rearranged a few little things and tweaked some stuff, and it just worked out beautifully. So
we're talking about the Dominion Caroloner, Andrea McCrady. She's done, I think she's played Taking Care of Business, another Canadian classic rock from those Peace Tower bells.
I can see that she could definitely do it.
She's got chops. Yeah.
No kidding. And chops, let me tell you, it's like an exercise class watching her go at it.
But, do you think it was hard to take your piece, given its musical complexity, and put it into the format of a Carillon bell?
Well, I kind of thought that might be fairly difficult. I start off with tritone, which is pretty dissonant as a kind of interval to start with. But she says actually with the way the overtones work on the Carillon, sometimes it works out even better when it's not perfectly, you know, even if it's very modern in sound, it can come across pretty good.
You get some serendipitous resonances.
Exactly.
Maybe, from the scaffolding in front of the building.
Exactly. Overtones ringing all over the place, but they seem to match with the stuff I've written. So, hey.
Great. How did she find out about what you're doing? How did she find out about the work in the first place?
Well, I think she came across the piece. We have 100 and some odd videos on YouTube right now from concerts that we've done over the years. And she came across it online and she thought, hey, this is a really neat piece. And I think she wanted to do a kind of a series on Canadian composers. So she sent me an email.
Tell
that
me
was
about
it.
The Stairwell Carolers. What's the sense of the name in the name?
Everybody asks that question.
Yeah.
Well, we started at Ottawa University when I was studying to do my degree in music. Started with just a bunch of friends. We would sing in the stairwells at the residences during exam time to entertain the students who were studying. So we'd start at the top of a residence stairwell and we'd open a door and we'd gather students until we got to the bottom and we'd have quite a crowd following us. But that's how I started. So we call ourselves the Stairwell Carolers.
Is it mainly because of the acoustics in the staircase? Or?
Of course. You know, we had just started there, so we needed that extra little help, you know.
And the staircase and the terrazzo floors are really, really hard surfaces?
Yeah, very resonant. A lot of echo and a lot of fun, too. But that's pretty much how it started in 1977. So this is our 36th season with
amazing.
The Carolers.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
What was your reaction when you found out that there was a possibility of it playing from the Carillon bells when you first heard that there was an interest in there?
Wow. Well, you know, what are you going to do? Yeah, I'm honored, super honored that this was going to happen at it's, again, like I said, it's a life moment for sure, you know. And plus we got to go up and we got to see the Carillon. We got to watch Andrea perform it again at 3 o'clock along with other songs. And it was very impressive to watch.
That's great. What's the inspiration behind the Christmas carol? What's it about?
Well, we had a pet bird that died and, you know, it was a bit traumatic thing for the family. And during the summer, I just thought, well, I've got this idea for a song, and I used the Mourning Dove call. And I interpolated that into, you know, my melody. And I used stuff that I had done even when I was an adolescent. The opening, the dissonant opening, is something I wrote when I was quite young. And I kind of put it in there and just made everything flow. Mm-hmm. And it worked out quite nice. So you can hear that dove call in the melody line, and it comes through quite well.
It's interesting, very fitting. I mean, a dove is also something emblematic of Christmas for people.
Definitely. And mourning being M-O-U-R-N, it has the double meaning. So.
Okay, I hadn't seen that, but that's good too. Now that you've heard your music played on the Carillon, will it change the way your choir performs it in the future? I mean, does that all feed back into what you do?
Probably not. I think I have a definite idea of how I want things to go, and it is my composition, so generally I have a tendency to do it the way I want it to be. And the choir is my instrument, and I work with them and make them sound exactly like I want them to sound. So,
did you get a recording today? Did you hold up some device to make a record of it?
I definitely did. I got my little MP3 device there, and my wife also put it on her camera, so we got a live footage. And there were a few choir members there. We had three or four choir members there, actually. One of them videotaped it too. So
great. And well, I guess it'll make its way onto your website from where all the videos are. One more video to add to the channel?
Perhaps. Yeah. Definitely. Well, the outdoor one will be. We wouldn't be putting anything on that was more in the private setting. But from the exterior, we probably will end up putting something up on YouTube for sure.
Fantastic. Well, congratulations. It's a nice
little
story.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming in.